Let's see the interface of Drone Designer. So these are the primitives. It's a cube, cylinder, sphere, ring. You just click on it and it will appear, double click on it actually, it will appear on the viewport, and you can select that and move around. You can see it also mentions its shortcut F9. So if it is not visible, you can press F9 and it will be highlighted like this. See? So the first is material editor. Here you will be applying material and colors to the objects, and it's one of the materials called standard one. So here you can change the colors as you may see. So and next one is object pool. Shortcut is F3. It's like hierarchy view, but it lists all the elements one after the other. So this is the camera, light, background, layout. We will discuss about this in later videos. And this is our cube. You can show hide it. This is the hierarchy view. You can collapse it. This is our light, camera, and cube. When you select an object from the hierarchy view, select that, click on this parameters. So when you select an object from hierarchy or from here, the parameters window will update and display the selected object's parameters. So you can see now here I am selecting cube, and we can change its width, height, and depth, center access point, sky alignment, this. And if you press shift and scroll, the change will be in multiples of 10, and if you press control, the changes will be multiples of 0.1 also. Yes, 0.1. So you can also manually feed the values. So if I can do this 180 and 150, depth 10. So this is that. Actually, 150. You can also soften the edges by chamfer. You can see now, but it's not rounded enough. So then we can increase the segments of the chamfer. So see, it's now rounded. And when you select an object, its transformation is visible here. So if you change the position, this will update accordingly, or you can change these values and the object will place itself on that position. If you right click on the arrows, it brings back to the property in its default value. So if you reset all, actually you can change its rotation, scale, and if you press reset all, it will reset all the values of the transformation panel. So see, okay, you can see I can rotate here, and I can place it here if I want. Actually, if I click once in the eye, it will be invisible from the viewport, but it is still exists and takes CPU power. But if I click twice, then it's turned into cross. It means it's render off. Actually, it will not affect the CPU power or GPU power anything anymore. So this is the one way you can hide them. Okay, so and this eye and this eye is different. It's not the same. This eye cannot be animated over time, but this eye will be animated. It's actually render state, and it is the opacity of the visibility, you may call it, if you hover it, visibility of the object. So if I place it here actually, and this is my playhead. When I press play on this icon here, it will start playing, but it's not visible because there aren't any many animations applied. So if I could just place it here and turn on auto key and click just once, or actually move it, then I will see it created a key, animation key, and then I will come back to frame 10 and move along with the actually change position of the sphere. Now you can see it's animating. Okay, and if I extend this, the animation takes longer. Now it's almost 1.5 seconds animation. Now it's about 2 seconds of animation in 30 fps. So let's play. See. Okay, and you can also show hide it. So actually, if I want to hide the visibility, I can click this. In 10 frames, I can click again. So then in 50 frames, I can click twice. Or if I want to delete, I will select and press delete. So if I want to copy this key here, I can select Control C and click here and Control V. That's one solution. Or if I want to copy this, there is one more solution. If I press shift and click and drag the key, it will be placed and duplicated at the position. So you can see this, here it's changing visibility, here it's still, and then here I will be turning its visibility off. So actually that's the basics, and I'm jumping around, I know. This is my first voice tutorial, so pardon me. Anyways, so this is the animation. If I just scroll up, here you will see the animation duration. Actually you can see here, it start here and ends here for this sphere object. You can shrink it or change the position. See, and now it will take start from 20 frames. The underlying keyframes will place itself accordingly. See. Anyways, so if I move the head to the start, or press Q and press play again, you will see it will start on frame 30. What if I want to use these 30 frames to do something with the cube? So I will select the cube and place the header where I want to start the animation, and place the cube at the position. Remember, you have to turn the auto key on, otherwise it won't create the automatic keyframes, and you will have to manually create it. So now if I drag along and at the frame 30, I can change its position by this or like this. I also want to actually rotate it at the duration. So what I will do, come at the frame, and you can see actually anytime these are the keyframes being created. Now I want to create a rotation keyframes. So I will place at the starting position of the animation, and click once in the rotation, anyone will do, and it will create the keyframe for its position. I will drag along and change the rotation. So let me see what I want. Okay, I want to turn it to 90 degrees and also 90 degrees, 80 and 90. Okay, that's now if we will see now. So if I press Q and press play, yeah, okay, you can see it animating first 30 frames. It's animating the cube. Then actually you can expand it other 30 frames. It will it's animating the sphere. So see, okay, so press and remember, when you are not animating anything and just checking, please turn off the auto key, otherwise your animation will be it will create all sorts of keyframes and you will be wondering what went wrong. So please turn off if it is not in use. Let me show you one more thing. If I press play, click Q and then play, it start and stops. What if I want to loop it? I will come to the top default header. It affects all its children or animations what comes below it. So all of these will be affected by the top animation control. So if I and there are situations where it you can turn off the parent. It is the parent of all for time being, and we will discuss other things in next video. So if I press play, so it's not looping, actually it's continuously going forward. Then what you can do is you can right click at frame 70 or so and add go to. Enter the number of frame. Whenever the playhead hits that keyframe, it will jump to what the frame what you select here. So if I choose frame 0 and okay, then it will start playing, and as soon as it hits this frame, it will see, oh, I have to jump to 0 frame, and it will be go at 0. I think that's enough for the video, and I will be updating the more videos. So please subscribe. Bye, take care.